now have the new administration in the office, and a lot of people celebrated, a lot of people have been clapping. What are some of the changes that are going to take place currently?
Well, if there's one president who's coming with all the good stuff and all the bells and whistles for the immigrants, it's Joe Biden. And what he's trying to accomplish for immigrants, I have to say, he's trying to achieve more than even what President Obama could achieve for the immigrant. This is a president who has come in full gear, caring about the immigrants in this country. And today we're going to talk about two particular areas because we don't have too much time and there's so much that we can cover, but we don't have enough time today. So today I want to concentrate because immigration keeps on changing and you need to update yourself. Whether you're an immigrant, as long as you're an immigrant or you have family members or friends who are immigrant, you need to keep yourself updated because this stuff affects you, or you may also be able to help a friend or a family member. So today we're going to talk about two stuff that President Joe Biden has come up with. First, I'm going to discuss in details about the hyped proposed immigration bill. And I say proposed because it hasn't been passed. This is just his game plan, what he has in plan for the immigrants. And then, if most of you follow up the news, he just signed some major executive orders in regard to immigration about a few days ago on Tuesday. I believe it was on February 2nd. And some major immigration executive orders. And then I'm going to talk on about public charge. Public charge is something new that came in last year. And it was brought by the former president, Trump. And the reason why I'm going to talk about that is because that is one of the things that affects right now a lot of the people trying to get a green card. And that is one of the reason why we could see a lot of people who qualify for green card may end up being denied a green card because of the public charge. So I'm going to discuss about those three things because they are very, very important and they are very, very vital to us as immigrants. Now, let me start with the one that everybody is excited about, because believe me, we have a lot of people without legal paperwork. We have a lot of people who are undocumented. You know, everybody is excited about this proposed bill because it's going to affect pretty much every single immigrant in this country is going to be affected by that law. Whether you have paperwork or not, you're going to be affected. Now, when I say propose, I want you guys to understand, this is a proposal, it hasn't been signed. And I don't want you to sit down thinking that you're going to wait until this proposed bill goes through for you to get your paperwork. Regardless of what the proposal says, I always tell people, you don't know what tomorrow holds. Because it's a proposal, it could go through Congress and Congress could refuse to go through with it, or they could suggest changes. So this proposal bill that I'm about to talk about, don't slack, don't sit down and say, oh, this is going to be my way to get myself legal, that you're not going to make an effort to get yourself legal. Don't bank on this, because even if it goes through, it may not be effective immediately. It could take time. But let me talk about this, the proposed bill that Joe Biden is suggesting. The proposed bill has two major areas, but the two major areas that everybody's excited about is creating a roadmap for citizenship for all undocumented individuals. And I say all, okay? Regardless, all. The only thing that could prevent you from getting or benefiting from this path to citizenship is if you have some criminal background. That could buy you. The second thing I'm going to talk about that affects the major area is about DACA. These are the people who came while they were young. They were brought here. And also we have TPS, which is the temporary protected status that sometimes people get. And we also have the farm workers. And by the way, guys, farm workers is a very good area for most of you to explore. As long as you're not afraid to work hard, explore into these farm jobs. You could get your way to get your green card. So it's not just about STEM. As most of you know, STEM, which is the science program, if you do a science-related or math-related or engineering-related degree, the other ways that you can also get your paperwork or your green card. Now, I'm not gonna waste time. Now, here, pick up your pen and paper, because now I start talking with the proposed bill, area number one, which is citizenship for all undocumented individuals. All, whether you have, as long as you don't have paperwork, you'll be able to benefit from this proposed bill. The proposed bill for undocumented, it has like an 8-year path. So you're going to get to citizenship, but it may take you a good 8 years before you can get your citizenship. Now, when that process, if it gets approved, the first thing you're going to get is you're going to get a temporary provisional legal status. You apply, you're able to get a work permit, you're able to continue working and doing everything you can. After that, you will have to apply for a green card. You'll stay with a green card for 5 years. After you've stayed with a green card for 5 years, you'll be able to transition to get your citizenship. So let me back up again. You apply for this provisional status. The provisional status combines together with the green card, because once you apply for the work permit or the provisional status, it does not give you any legal paperwork. In other words, it's like you're on probation for a duration of 5 years. After that 5 years, of course, you'll apply to get a green card. Once you get your green card, as of right now, for you to become a citizen, normally you'd wait 5 years with a green card before you apply for citizenship. But on Joe Biden's proposal, because you'd have already stayed 5 years with your provisional status, and then you apply for a green card, once you get a green card, you will stay 3 years with your green card as a legal permanent status for 3 years. Which is different, because right now for you to apply for citizenship, you have to be a green card holder for 5 years. But under Joe Biden proposal, you will only stay with your green card for 3 years. After 3 years, you apply for citizenship. So it's an 8-year path. So 5 years with a temporary provisional status, that just gives you like work permit. You have to show you're a good person, of course. You have to show you're paying your taxes. You also have to make sure you don't get yourself in trouble by getting yourself in any criminal or any problem with the law. After your 5-year provisional, then you transition to become a green card holder. You become a green card holder for 3 years. After 3 years of a green card holder, then you apply to be a citizen. So we're talking about a duration of 8 years. That is for all undocumented. The only condition for you to be able to benefit is you have to have been in the United States before January 1st, 2021. Now, this is the good part about this new proposal. There are people who got deported back home. They can still also apply through this process. They have to show that they have family here, or they want to be reunited with their family, or it has to be for humanitarian grounds.
Sure.
Okay. If you can prove that, even the people who are deported prior to January 20th, write this date down, January 20th, 2017. Those people, as long as they can show they were in the country prior to January 20th, 2017, they were physically here in the United States, and they had lived in the United States for 3 years before being deported, they will be able to apply and come back through this proposal that Joe Biden is making. The second people who will benefit from this Joe Biden proposal are people who are DACA. Of course, we know those are the deferred adjudication people who came here while they were young. We have the TPS holder, and we have the farm workers. For DACA people, TPS holders, and for immigrant farm workers, their path to citizenship is going to be 3 years. For them, the reason is 3 years is because they will be eligible to apply for green card immediately. And like all these other undocumented individual, for those special category, DACA, TPS, and farm workers, they'll be able to apply for a green card immediately. After they get their green card, they have to stay 3 years as green card holder, and then they apply for citizenship. Those are the two categories, and that is the biggest hype that everybody have. As I talked about, the requirement is very, very simple. Just being present in the United States prior to January 1st, 2021. And also for people who've been deported, they'll be able to benefit from it as long as they were in the country prior to January 20, 2017, and they lived here for 3 years. And all you have to show is pay your taxes. If there'll be any penalties imposed, pay any penalties, and also pass a background check. That is as simple as that when it comes to that. The other thing is, we all know about work-related visas. Joe Biden wants to make sure that he includes immigrants as much as possible to the growth of the American economy. So one of the things that he's proposing is he wants to make sure that the current employment-based visa log is cleared. He also wants to make sure, and this is where most of you who are F1 students need to pay attention and do degrees that when you graduate, they are going to be degrees that will help you. There's what we call STEM degrees, as most of you know, which is science, technology, engineering, and math degrees. Okay? He wants to make it easier. If you graduate with one of those STEM degrees, that you'll be able to stay in the United States, because he wants to make sure that those visas, work-related or STEM visas, are easily available to immigrants. Right now, it's difficult to get it. The number is usually capped very tight, and the waiting list is usually very, very huge. He wants to eliminate all that. And the good part is, once you get, like, for example, the H-1B visas, once you get that visa, your spouse will also be able to get like work authorization with you to continue working here as you wait for your green card to be processed. The other thing that he wants to know, and I know this affects most of us, asylum. Right now, as you all know, there's 1 year deadline after you land in the country to apply for an asylum. If you apply more than past 1 year, you have to give an explanation on why you filed after 1 year. And unfortunately, in most of those, over 50% of those filed over 1 year, they end up rejecting them and referring them to the immigration judge. And then the immigration judge will want to know why you filed. If the immigration judge is not convinced, the immigration judge is not even going to give you an opportunity to present your case. So one of the things that also Joe Biden's proposal wants to do is eliminate that 1 year filing deadline. That way, if you come and at any time you feel you're afraid to go back to your country, or you have a need to apply for an asylum, you can apply. You're not locked out. You don't have to jump all this hurdle to prove why you filed more than 1 year late. The other thing is, as barbaric as it may sound, for all immigration laws, we are known as aliens, okay? We are known as foreign objects or aliens. That's how they refer us in all immigration laws. We are aliens, but Joe Biden wants to eliminate that word alien so that we can be called non-citizen, okay? I know that's tribal, but for the self-esteem and to show people that immigrants are also human beings, Joe Biden wants to change also that word from an alien to be called a non-citizen. So the other thing that he also wants to do is, as most of you know, if you overstay and you get deported, there's a limitation on when you can come back to the country. There's a 3 year or 10 year ban depending on how long you've been in the country. So he wants to eliminate that. In other words, if you get deported and you have family here, you can reapply to come back immediately. You don't have to wait for all this time before you can come back. And this affects most of us who are parents, because sometimes we get deported, our kids grow up, they get to an age where they can file for us. But because you overstay, you can't benefit from that green card that your kid has applied for you. Or sometimes we have people who get deported. They try and go and apply for green card, DV lottery, and they win DV lottery. But because you overstayed, you have a ban, you cannot come back. Joe Biden wants to eliminate that ban. Also, let's say, for example, you are a citizen, you've applied for your sister or brother. You know the wait time, right, as of right now, if you apply for a sister or brother, is around 12 to 16 years. So most of that time, most people will run out of status, and you cannot adjust in the country if you're out of status. Or if you're a parent and you apply for your child who's over 21 years old, by the time they get a visa number available for them, they're out of status, they can't adjust here. They have to leave the country. The problem becomes because they leave the country, they can't come back here because they are banned because of the overstay. Or another example, you're a spouse of a green card holder. If you're a spouse of a green card holder, you cannot adjust here in the United States unless you're in good immigration status. That is why they always tell you get married to a citizen, not to a green card holder. If you leave, if you apply for your spouse or your children as a green card holder, they have to leave and then come back if they're out of status. But eliminating that 3 to 10 year ban if you're out of status when you get deported or when you leave will be able also to help people who are green card holder to apply for their spouses who are out of status. So that is a summary of Joe Biden proposal. And I say a proposal because it hasn't passed to law yet. Okay, it's just a proposal.